Welcome back to Positively Port St. Lucie. I'm Sarah Prohaska here at the City of Port St. Lucie's Communications Department. Our show is rolling along with another, I'm really pleased to have this guest on. He's here to talk about some really exciting things happening in the western part of our city and an area called Southern Grove, which anyone familiar with the city has probably heard that term. It's our jobs corridor out in Tradition. Along 95, and Richard Tamboni has been, the city contracted with Richard Tamboni and his company to help market 84 acres out there called the Tradition Center for Commerce. And I'm so pleased to have Richard Tamboni on with me today. Thank you, Richard, for taking the time out of your busy, I know you're extremely busy out there at Southern Grove, schedule to come with us today. Thanks. Great.
Thank you very much, Sarah. Most appreciative.
No problem. So, the Tradition Center for Commerce, the city contracted with your company to help us market that area. It's 84 acres, and there's been some really exciting things happening. And it's 84 acres. If you could kind of give us a general idea, the public, of where that is.
Absolutely. So it's part of the overall 1,200 acres, mm-hmm. and we decided to kind of focus on the northern portion of the 1,200 acre mm-hmm. site because most of all the utilities are ready to go.
Mm-hmm.
And also because of all the activity that's being transmitted in the northern portion of the area,
yeah.
it made sense to keep the economic activity moving.
Yeah.
So we focused on the 84 acres. Mm-hmm. We worked with the city mm-hmm. to kind of come up with the best acreage that makes the most sense.
Yeah.
And we started marketing it about 4 months ago.
All right. And this is 84 acres. So for the layman, it's so Southern Grove is generally along the western stretch of 95 between the Becker Road exit on 95 and the Gatlin Boulevard exit on 95. That's just the general vicinity of 1,200 acres that we call Southern Grove.
Correct.
These 84 acres is kind of, it's on the northern end of that, and it's anyone who knows where Tradition Hospital is, Cleveland Clinic's new hospital, Kaiser University, Torrey Pines Institute for Molecular Studies. It's in that vicinity on the northern stretch of this.
That's exactly right.
All right. So, and I just named a few really great things that are in this area. So I know you've been working too, and we have recruited or we've able to attract new businesses to this area in the short time that you've been working with the city. Can you kind of tell us about some of the new businesses we'll see out there?
Absolutely. Uh-huh. It's been rather exciting. And as you mm-hmm. mentioned, I think if you're going down I-95, either north or south, mm-hmm. people now notice this 400,000 square foot building mm-hmm. that just got completed by City Electric.
Yes.
So the 84 acres kind of encompasses land to the south and west of that property. Mm-hmm. And so when we started marketing the property, and we worked with Firefly and a bunch of local companies mm-hmm. from the marketing side, mm-hmm. we got incredible guidance from the standpoint of what the market was looking for.
Okay.
So we started going to the marketplace, started mm-hmm. marketing it both through all the Port St. Lucie County mm-hmm. brokers mm-hmm. and brokers to the south, and we were fortunate enough to immediately land two major companies, mm-hmm. one of which is Brightworks,
okay.
which is a development company that is going to purchase about 6 acres of land and develop 60,000 square feet of office, medical, and retail space.
Okay.
And then just to the south of them, we're working with a company out of Miami called AAHS yes. Residential,
mm-hmm.
which is really exciting because they're going to develop about 376 apartment units.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people say, gosh, there's enough apartments in the area.
Uh-huh.
In reality, they're kind of focused on what I call the workforce housing.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So the rental rates in a high-quality building mm-hmm. will be less than what the market is.
Okay.
And so that's really great for a lot that of the young professionals and people going to college mm-hmm. that can remain in their own backyard and go to school, as you mentioned, at the Kaiser
yeah.
or the hospital at the Cleveland Clinic.
Yeah, exactly. And it's a mix of a lot of different uses out there because you have your industrial, you have your residential, you have your medical. And Cleveland Clinic is a big part of now our whole energy out there because Cleveland Clinic bought Tradition merged with Martin Memorial Medical Systems. And they now have the hospital out there. And we just had some really exciting news about what we call the Florida Center for Biosciences. A lot of people know it as the former VGTI, Vaccine and Gene Therapy Institute building. Out there, VGTI had the building, occupied the building, but during the Great Recession, left town. The city owns this building, and we've been trying to find an occupant for it. And just last week, Cleveland Clinic Lerner Research Institute, their research leg is going to occupy that building, which is fantastic economic development news for our area. And they have to bring in them under the lease a minimum of 100 jobs in 5 years, but we fully expect it to be more. And
yeah. It's very exciting yes. news. I mean, to get the Cleveland Clinic, not only to get involved in the hospital side, mm-hmm. but this will be the first time in the history of the Cleveland Clinic that they're actually going to have researchers outside of the Cleveland, Ohio area yeah. to come down here to Port St. Lucie. Mm-hmm. So them tying in with FIU
yes.
in a company called Vaccine, mm-hmm. a company out of Australia, which is in vaccine therapy.
Uh-huh.
They're combining as a team, and they'll be leasing the old BGTI building.
Yeah.
And so now what the initial use was going to be for, mm-hmm. quite candidly, this use, what's going to be occurring with the Cleveland Clinic and these team players, could not be stronger for our marketplace. And then you have FIU.
FIU, Florida yeah. International University. Yeah. yeah.
Tying into it, not only with that facility, mm-hmm. but also getting involved further with the Torrey Pines Institute.
Yeah, which is out there too. And they've been in our area a long time. They've been a presence in this area for
yes.
a long time, and they've been doing their research out there. And yeah, they recently announced that they're hoping to have I think I read that it may be being finalized sometime in January, their partnership with Florida International University, which brings a whole new university presence to Port St. Lucie, which is great.
Absolutely. It's very exciting.
Yeah.
Because if you start combining those forces
mm-hmm.
in that environment, it only creates an environment for others to say they made that decision, they've made that capital investment,
mm-hmm.
they're getting the quality researchers and scientists coming to the market.
Yep.
That only gives other companies the reasons for wanting to come to the city of Port St. Lucie.
Yeah.
And then we can't forget
yeah.
as well the good news that Oculus,
yes, yeah, Oculus Surgical. Yeah.
yeah. They just got announced. We've been the city's been working with them for about a year,
mm-hmm.
and they just signed the contract mm-hmm. in full, and they just closed on the property last week.
Okay.
And so this is a 50,000 square foot. Will be the U.S. corporate offices.
Okay.
This is a company out of Germany
mm-hmm.
that's consolidating a couple operations in our local area, but as well as they're bringing their manufacturing from Germany to city of Port
yeah.
St. Lucie. So that's exciting.
It's very exciting to have all the manufacturing is an important segment of the economy, and that combined with City Electric Supply, which you mentioned. And I get questions all the time about that building because it's huge. It's a big
yes, it
building
is.
And they have really cool lights on the front of it
mm-hmm.
that you can see from I-95, and people have asked me a lot lately, what is that building with the lights on 95? And I say it's City Electric Supply, and it's I believe right now the biggest square footage wise building in the city. So it's really great, all this activity and the interaction and the synergy
Absolutely.
Happening out there in the Tradition Center
and then
for Commerce.
To the south of that now,
uh-huh.
City Electric.
Yes.
City's working with a company called Accel.
Accel.
Out of Connecticut.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And they're a wire company, okay. wire manufacturer,
mm-hmm.
cable and wire manufacturer. And so I expect that in the next 9 months, that should be under construction. And that brings more job opportunities here to the city as well.
Right.
And that's what gets lost, as you know, you combine all of these companies
yeah.
and with the Cleveland Clinic and
mm-hmm.
the FIU expanding
mm-hmm.
and with the vaccine company, the number of new job opportunities
oh, yeah.
at very good wages mm-hmm. is significant.
Yes.
And that's why they want to make this the jobs corridor as part of the Tradition Project.
Exactly. Yeah. No, and it is. And but there is more acreage available, right?
Absolutely.
Out there at the Tradition
yes.
Center for Commerce. And I know that you have recently set up a website to
yes.
market that area. So please be on the lookout for that.
TamboniTradition.com.
There you go. TamboniTradition.com. yep. And I have no idea who's listening to this,
yeah.
but you know, if you're interested in learning more, that's a great place to go to get the stats on what's
Absolutely.
Happening out there.
I have to mention one more
sure,
thing, if you don't
yeah.
mind.
Uh-huh.
This is a total collaboration
mm-hmm.
between the city of Port St. Lucie and our companies, the Tamboni companies.
Mm-hmm.
And I can only tell you that working with yourselves in the communications department,
oh.
with the mayor,
mm-hmm.
the city council members, Wes McCurry is our daily contact from the CRA,
yeah.
and you deal with Elijah and then the EDC.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
When you combine this strength of individuals in the city involvement, we can only make this a success.
Yeah.
And you can see by the amount of companies that are coming now to yeah. Port St. Lucie, this is just the beginning of it all.
That's great. Yep. So we really do hope to see more of this exciting news happening. I love releasing the press releases saying more exciting news happening in our jobs corridor, because it's great to just keep building on it.
And absolutely,
it really is. It was a pleasure talking to you today about all the. I can tell your excitement for it, and I think that's how we feel at the city too. So
thank you very much for the opportunity, I look forward to coming back with good news.
We'll have you back on next in a couple months. Hopefully, we'll have some more updates.
Right, thank you so much.
I know people are interested in this area, so thank you. I appreciate it. And we'll be right back after these messages.